Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. This is Antony Vijay. Today we are going to see about operators in C programming. So let me see the concept of C operators. So when I talk about operators, there are various types. Arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, bitwise operator, assignment operator, special operator. So when I talk about arithmetic operators, there are various basic operators like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and modulo operators are there. So we are going to see this explanation through CodeBlocks IDE. So first of all, I start with the basic program, hash include stdio.h. Then I mention main function, and opening the curly braces and closing the curly braces. Here I am going to declare the three variables, a, b, c. So now I am going to do addition of two numbers. So for that I am using printf statement here. Enter the value for a and b. Okay, it will be shown on the screen. After that I am using runtime input for giving value for a and b. So for that purpose I am using 2 times %d. It means I am giving value for a and b. So ampersand a comma ampersand b, so two values. So I am end with the semicolon. After that I am using c equal to a plus b, addition operation. Now I am going to print the result using printf statement. The result of c is equal to, we have to mention %d again because this is integer. So after the double quotes we have to mention c because the result is stored in c, and end with the semicolon like this. Okay, now I build the program, so no warnings and no errors. Now I run the code. See, we are getting enter the value for a and b like this. Okay, we are going to give value for a and b. So I am giving for a is 12 and for b is 23. So addition of 12 and 23 is 35. So this is the result of addition operator. When we talk about subtraction, so we have to replace the plus symbol with the minus symbol. That's all. Okay, no other go. Simply small change like this. Once again, I build it and run the code. Now I give the value for a and b. Now I am giving 34 for a, and for b it is 56, so it will give you minus 22 because 34 minus 56 is minus 22. So this is the result for subtraction of two numbers. When I go for multiplication, the same. So instead of minus, we have to replace with the multiplication symbol. That's all. Now once again build and run. Now I give the value for a is 5 and for b is 7, so it's supposed to be 5 into 7, it is 35. So this is the result of multiplication of two numbers. And when I talk about division, okay, when I talk about division, so this is integer, so it will only give whole numbers. Okay, it will not print the decimal values. So let me see that. So I'll build and run the program. Okay, if I give 32 for a and 6 for b, it will give you 5. It means the decimal part will be truncated. Truncated means removed. Okay, because so in this area we are only taking care of integer. If you want the decimal value also, now we have to change this integer as a float. Okay, so keep in mind. When I talk about modulo operator, we have to replace with the modulo symbol. This is a percentage symbol. We usually say like this. So once again, build and run the program. So actually, this modulo operator will give you the remainder. Okay. See, if I'm giving 15 for A and 4 for B. So 15 divided by 4. The remainder value is what? 3. So 3 is the result. So usually the modulo symbol will give you the remainder of the result. Okay. So this is what the arithmetic operator. So arithmetic operator usually contains addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and finally modulo operator. So these 5 operators are comes under the category of arithmetic operator. Okay. When we talk about increment operator, like there are two different types. One is pre-increment and the other one is post-increment. And when we talk about decrement operator, same as increment operator, here also two types, like pre-decrement and post-decrement. So we will see the explanation about increment and decrement operator through code blocks IDE. So first of all, we are going to see about increment operator. So as usual, we have to mention the header file. And main function, so curly braces. So inside I am using a variable a having a value 5. Okay, I am declaring a variable. Now I am going to use pre-increment. Okay, for that I want to display the result using printf statement. Result of a is equal to, so this is integer. So I want to use percentage G. So put comma here, then plus plus A. This is what pre-increment. So let me see the result. So first of all, I build it and run the code. It is showing the result of A is 6. It means the value of A is incremented by 1. So this is what pre-increment. In the place of pre-increment, if I replace with the A plus plus, that is called as post-increment. Okay. So post increment usually used in looping statements like for, while and do while loop. So if you use like this, your result will not increase. See the result once again. So we will get the same answer only, 5 only there. There is no increment here. Okay. When I talk about pre increment, the value will be increased immediately. But when I talk about post increment, the value will not increase immediately. It will increase in the next iteration only. So that is why this type of increment operator used in looping statements. Okay. Now we are going to see about a decrement operator. So when I talk about decrement operator, first we are going to see about a pre-decrement. So I am using minus minus a. Okay. So this is pre-decrement. Now I build and run the program. See, the result of A is 4. So it means minus minus A means A equal to A minus 1. It is reducing a value by 1. So here also the value is immediately reduced. But if I mention A minus minus, the value will not reduce immediately. Let's see that. Build and run the program here. See, it will show you the same result. So that is why most of the time if you see in the looping statement, usually use a minus minus or a plus plus, because these type of post increment and post decrement usually in looping statements. Okay, because it increase in the next iteration only. So this is what increment and decrement operator, assignment operator. So when I talk about assignment operator, usually an expression is supposed to have equal to symbol. That type of operators are called as assignment operators. See here, a equal to b, a equal to a plus b, a equal to a minus b. So this type of basic calculations comes under assignment operator. So let me see some examples for assignment operators through code blocks IDE. Okay, so as usual, we have to mention the header file, hash include stdio.h, and include the main function. So here we are going to add two numbers. So for that I am giving for A is 5 and for B is 10, and I am including one more variable. So I want to store the value to C. Okay. So here I am using C equal to A plus B. So this line is called as assignment operator. Assignment operator is available between C and A plus B. So that is why it is called as assignment operator. So wherever we are using equal to symbol, that operator is called as assignment operator. Now we are printing the result through printf statement. So percentage D. So I'm using the result of C is. Okay, and comma C at the end we have to put semicolon. Right. Now I build and run the program. See, the result of C is 15. So 10 plus 5 is 15. This is a general calculation of assignment operator, relational operator. Okay, the operator which is used to find the relationship between two variables known as relational operator. Here equal to, greater than, lesser than, lesser than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to. These operators are comes under relational operator. When I talk about relational operator, it will produce only 0 or 1. It means if the condition is true, it will produce 1. Otherwise, it will produce 0. So here in this example, 5 equal to 3. So this condition is wrong. So if the condition is wrong, it will produce 0. See the next example. Here 5 greater than 3. The condition is true here. So it will produce 1. You can see this explanation through CodeBlocks IDE. A header file. Main function. So here we will see the explanation about relational operator. So here I am using variable like A, B and one more variable, that is the result. Okay, so result will be used to find the result whether it is equal or not. We will see that first. So result equal to, for example, if I am giving A greater than B. Okay, so here I am giving for A is 50 and for B is 20. Okay, now I am printing the result. Print up the result of A greater than B is equal to percentage D. Here I am using A greater than B. Okay, and finally end with the semicolon. Let me see the result. Now I build the program and run the code. Okay, the result of A greater than B is 1. 1 means what? The condition is true. If the condition is false, it will be 0. So this is what the general thing. If I mention A less than B, okay, so now we can check the result. Okay, see, it is showing 0. 0 means what? The condition fails. So if the condition fails, it will 0. Otherwise, it will give you 1. So this is the general relationship between two variables. So this is what a relational operator. So relational operator like greater than symbol, less than equal to symbol also there. So I will give you one more example for that also. In case if I mention A equal to 50 and B also 50. Okay, so I am using less than equal to. So less than equal to means what? It may be lesser than or equal to value. Okay, so I build and run the code. So it is showing 1. It means the condition is true. So this is the general relationship between variable A and B. So that can be identified by relational operator. Okay, logical operator. When I talk about logical operator, it fully depends on expression. If the expression is true, it will give you 1. Otherwise, it will give you 0. This is the result the logical operator will produce. Usually, expressions contain conditions. When I talk about logical operator, there are three operators we are following, like logical AND, logical OR, and finally logical NOT. So in logical AND operator, both the conditions supposed to be true. If both the conditions are true, the result will be 1. Otherwise, it will be 0. This is the rule we are following for logical AND. And for logical OR, either any one of the condition or both the conditions supposed to be true. This is the rule for logical OR. So logical NOT means like it will invert the condition. If the condition is true, it will invert. It means it will convert into false. If the condition is false, it will convert as true. So this is the general process for logical NOT. So let me see the explanation about this operator through CodeBlocks IDE. So as usual, we have to start with the header file. Then main function. curly braces. Here I am going to declare a variable. So I'm using three variable A, B, C, and one more variable for finding out the result of expression, that is result. Okay. So here I am giving value for variable A, B, C. For A it is 15, and for B it is 10, and for C it is 20. So I am assigning the result now. Result equal to, I am giving condition for result. Okay. So the first condition is A greater than B. Now we are going to check for logical AND operator. For that we have to mention 2 times ampersand symbol. Once again round brackets you have to mention here. So A equal to B. A equal to B. So 2 conditions I am mentioning here. So let me check A greater than B. The first condition is correct because A is 15, B is 10. So the first condition is true. When I talk about second condition, A equal to B. So the second condition is wrong. Logical AND operator, if any one of the condition is fail, the result will be 0 only. Let me check the result. So I am using printf statement to print the result. The result is equal to percentage D I am using, put comma, then I am mentioning result variable here. Now I build the code, then run the code. See, the result is 0 because the second condition is false. If both the condition is true, now we will get the correct answer. So I am changing this condition. So I am using not equal to B. So not equal to B means what? Right now A is 15 and B is 10. So the second condition also true and first condition also true. Now the result is supposed to be 1. See the result. See, the result is 1. So this is what logical AND operator. Now we go for logical OR operator. So in the place of logical AND, I am replacing with the logical OR. Okay, so 2 times we have to mention the pipeline symbol. So for logical OR operator, either any one of the conditions supposed to be true or both the conditions supposed to be true, then we will get the result as 1. Okay, so here both the conditions are true. Okay, now I change the second condition as A equal to B. It means the first condition is true, the second condition is false, but the logical OR will give the result as 1. See, the result is 1. So this is what a logical OR. So logical OR, any one of the condition is required to be true. Okay, this is what logical OR operator. Then when I talk about NOT operator, so for logical NOT operator we need only one condition. So first of all we have to start with a NOT operator here. This is an exclamatory symbol, so you have to mention here, and within a bracket we have to mention any one of the condition. For example, A greater than B. A greater than B. So actually A greater than B is the correct condition. It is a true only, but logical NOT will invert. Invert means if it is true, it will produce false. See the result. It will give you 0. See, the result is 0. It means it will invert the result. This is what happening. And in case if I mention the condition wrongly, A less than B. So A less than B means what? Condition fail. But outside I am using NOT operator, so it will give you the result as 1, true. Okay, see the result. The result is 1. So this is what logical NOT operator. These are the 3 operators comes under logical operators. Bitwise operator. So when you talk about bitwise operator, it will do some bit level calculation. So in this operator is having 6 different operators like bitwise and OR, exclusive OR, bitwise complement, shift left and shift right. So totally we are having 6 different operators are available under bitwise operator. So let me see one by one through CodeBlocks IDE. So as usual we have to start with the header file hash include stdio.h. then we have to mention the main function, then include the curly braces. So here I'm giving value for 2 variable, A equal to 12, B equal to 25. Okay, now I'm going to find bitwise AND. Okay, so I'm going to print the result. For that I'm using printf statement. the result of A ampersand B. A ampersand B means A bidwise AND B. Okay. This is the difference between bidwise AND and logical AND. In logical AND, we supposed to use two ampersand symbol. For bidwise AND, we supposed to use only one ampersand symbol. And equal to symbol, then we have to put percentage D here. Okay. Then put comma, and here we have to mention A ampersand B. Okay. Then end with the semicolon. Now we see the result. Okay. I build the code and run the code. The result is 8 here. Okay. When I talk about bitwise operation, we will not calculate directly through our mind. We have to do some manual operation because it is bit by bit process. So let me see how to calculate the manual operation. So just I go back to the slide once again. See here, so I'm taking two values, 12, 25. A equal to 12 and B equal to 25. First of all, we have to convert this 12 in terms of binary with 8 bits, okay. Then at the same time for 25 also, we have to convert in a binary format. So this is bitwise AND. So for AND, we have to follow the AND truth table. So as you know already, for AND truth table, both X and Y supposed to be true, then only it will be 1. For other options, it will be 0. So right now we are going to do AND operation. So 1, 0, it is 0. 1, 1, it is 1. So all the other will be 0. So finally, we get the answer as 8. This is what bitwise AND operator. Okay, next we will see about bitwise OR operator. So if you want to find bitwise OR operator, in the place of ampersand, you have to use the pipeline symbol. Okay, let me see the result here. The answer is 29. I go back to the PPT. See here. The same value I have given for A and B, again 12 and 25. So same binary value for 12 and 25. Now we have to follow for bitwise OR. So for OR, I already told you either any one of the condition or both the conditions supposed to be true, then only we will get the answer as 1 1. Okay. For other options, it will be 0. So here we are going to do bitwise OR operation. So for 0 1, it will be 1, and for 0 0, it is 0. 1 0 1. 1 1 1 and 0 1 also 1. All other three zeros, it will be 0. So while converting the binary into decimal, we are getting 29. This is the background process for bitwise OR operation. Now we can calculate the bitwise exclusive OR operation. So for that purpose, we have to replace the OR operator with this cap operator. This cap operator means this is called as exclusive OR operator, bitwise exclusive OR operator. So let me see the result of this. It is showing 21. Let me see the manual calculation. So we have to go back to PPT. In bitwise exclusive OR, okay, there is a truth table for bitwise exclusive OR. So here the corresponding bits of two operands supposed to be opposite. It means if x value 1, y value supposed to be 0. If y value is 1, x value supposed to be 0. So in this case, it will give you 1. For all other cases, it will be 0. So the same manner, we are giving value for 12 and 25. So 0, 1, both are opposite. So it will be giving 1. 0, 0, 0. Then 1, 0, it is also opposite values. So it will be giving 1. So finally, converting the binary to decimal value, we are getting 21. This is the general process about bitwise exclusive OR. So now we are going to see about shift operators. Shift operators are used to shift the bits either right side or left side. Accordingly, there are two types: right shift operator and left shift operator. So right shift operator using a symbol called 2 times greater than symbol, and for left shift operator, it is using a symbol 2 times lesser than symbol. So let me see the explanation about right shift operator. For right shift operator, so it is used to shift the elements towards right. It means if I shift 2 bits right, 2 zeros will be inserted in the front. If I shift 7 bits right, automatically 7 zeros will be added in the front. So this is what right shift operator. So I will explain this through code blocks. Hash include stdio.h void main Okay, here I am giving value for a. A equal to 212. So I am going to use right shift operator. So for right shift operator, I have to use A 2 times greater than symbol. I am going to use 2 bits. Okay. Now I am built in and run the code. See, it is giving 53. If we shift 2 bits right, the result will be different. In case if I shift for 7 bits, so I want to replace with this 7, the answer will be 1. So this is the thing. Okay, if I shift for 7 bits, all the 7 bits will be 0 and only 1 bit will be 1. So that's why we are getting the result as 1. Okay, this is what right shift. When I talk about left shift operator, so all the bits are shifted towards left, and at the same time, if I shifted for 4 bits, 4 zeros will be added at the end. So this is what left shift operator. So now we are going to find 212 left shift operator for 4 bits. See through code blocks. So now I go for left shift operator for 4 bits. Our answer is supposed to be 3392. Let me check it here. So I build and run the code. See, 3392. So this is the result for left shift operator. So initially it is 212. For one shift, one zero is added at the end. For no shift, nothing is added. If I shifted for 4 bits, 4 zeros is added at the end. So that's why we are getting a bigger value, like 3392. So this is what a left shift operator. Okay, guys, if you are having any queries, just mention in the comment box. I will clarify your doubts. And if you want to take any topics, just mention in the comment box. I will clear your doubts in upcoming sessions. Please like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you very much for watching.